think one of the key areas that courts have been looking at recently has been the application of trademarks in the online space, whether that be the use of a competitor's mark on a web page or social media site, to the more invisible forms of use, such as meta tags and the purchase of competitor marks in keyword programs. So one of the key cases this year was Vader and Maloof, in which there was a definitive finding that the purchase of a keyword was not trademark use. So going forward, courts, I think, will be spending a lot of time applying traditional legal notions such as what is trademark use, what constitutes a badge of origin, who are the ordinary consumers to these emerging technologies, and the application of trademarks in those new forums. I think a key trend to look out for in 2017 is globalisation. The impact of Brexit on Australian businesses, particularly with the application of their IP rights in the EU, should be something that we're mindful of, whether contractual arrangements that currently specify the EU will still cover UK post-Brexit. The Australian government has also been addressing the issue of globalisation by appointing David Bennett as the inaugural IP councillor in China. So I think that's recognition that Australian businesses consider China to be a key export market and also very interested in being able to protect their IP in that jurisdiction.